My name is Jim Thomas, and welcome to the Fitness Management Update. Our topic today is tips to buying a gym business for sale. And tip number one is, you know, there's a lot of different gyms out there. I mean, from 1,000 square feet up to, you know, 100,000 square feet. Fitness centers, health club, gyms, studios, all shapes and sizes. Make sure that you're familiar with the type of gym that you're looking for. Make sure you're familiar with their products and make sure that you're familiar, you know, with the services they offer. Make sure you ideally have some background in that would be great. Okay. Next, you know, buying a business, you know, buying a health club, I mean, there's going to be some long hours. There's going to be, you know, you're the first one there. You're the last one to leave. You're going to be there on weekends. You're probably going to be working some holidays. You know, do you have the support of your family? Okay, or those people that are close to you that support this endeavor. If they don't, this could be an issue. Or number two, you know, you just may have to distance yourself from those folks that do not offer that kind of support. Next, did you research the market and analyze your competition? Do you know what's going on in this marketplace? Don't just look at P&Ls. Look at, hey, what's the opportunity for growth? What's the competition doing? How are you different? How are you unique? Did you check, Yelp reviews? You know, what are people saying? You know, what's the image like? Have you talked to vendors? I mean, make sure you do your research on what's going on. Next would be, you know, do you have sufficient funds, you know, to do this? What we look for is we like to see, say it costs, you know, $100,000 a month, you know, to run this business. You know, we like to have you see you have at least $100,000 in cash reserves, you know, sitting there. Make sure you've got enough funds available. You know, and one of the things that's key to having success in any gym or fitness centers that you buy is certainly going to be, you know, positive attitude and things of this nature. But when you're buying this, you don't want to find yourself being blinded by optimism. You know, you want to look at the reality of it, make sure you're doing your research, you know exactly what's happening. Next on our list is, you know, do you genuinely know, you know, why the owner is selling? You know, they'll tell you, you know, retirement or other opportunities. Okay, that's great. But the more you can find out what this reason is, you know, have they lost key personnel? Have they lost a key corporate account? You know, is there, you know, a new competitor coming to town that maybe you're not aware of? So, you know, make sure you know, why the owner is selling, or at least, you know, do the research to, you know, help you understand this. Have you contacted other gym owners with similar operations? You know, whatever type facility you're looking at, you know, go outside the marketplace and contact other gym owners and ask them about the pros and cons of that particular type of facility. You know, the more understanding you can have, the better chance you're going to have a success when you get in here. And then finally, you know, are you getting advice and assistance from experts? And I'm talking about, you know, people that have a history in this industry, you know, proven background in this industry to help you with an evaluation, to help you with an analysis, to even be that additional set of eyes looking at something, perhaps even a little more objectively, because again, one of the things that can happen is we can get blinded by optimism when we're doing some of this. So here's some tips to buying a gym business. It's a great industry to be in. It's a growing industry. And if you do your research and you buy it right, getting an existing business, you know, you get an existing clientele, existing cash flow, and a chance really to grow a pretty good opportunity for yourself. My name is Jim Thomas, and this has been the Fitness Management Update.